क्लास सिक्स चैप्टर टेन मोशन एंड मेजरमेंट ऑफ डिस्टेंसेस। स्टोरी ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट। लॉन्ग एगो पीपल डिड नॉट हैव एनी मीन्स ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट। दे यूज टू मूव ओनली ऑन फुट एंड कैरी गुड्स आइदर ऑन देयर बैक और यूजिंग एनिमल्स। फॉर ट्रांसपोर्ट अलॉन्ग वाटर रूट्स Boats were used. The earliest human beings move only on foot. Then they start domesticating animals, and these animals carried men and goods from one place to another. For traveling on water, wooden logs with a hollow cavity in them were used. Children, you are seeing in the pic boat, this is just like a wooden block with a cavity in the center. Now gradually men learned to join logs to make rafts, and the wooden planks were also used to make boats. Invention of wheel. Invention of the wheel made a great change in the modes of transport. It makes land transport easier. The design of the wheel was improved over thousands of years. Animals were used to pull vehicles that moved on wheels. Children, you are seeing here the pic of wheel. In the second pic, bullocks were used to pull the cart that has wheels. Steam engines. Until the beginning of the 19th century, people still depended on animal power to transport them from place to place. Animal power like camel, bullocks, horses, these were used to carry carts. The invention of steam engine introduced a new source of power. In 19th century, steam engines, this was invented, and it made a big change in the way people traveled. Carriages, rails and boats could all be driven by steam engine, and this made travel very fast. Automobiles. Then came automobiles. Motorized boats and ships were used as means of transport on water. The early years of 1990 saw the development of aeroplanes. These were later improved to carry passengers and goods. Electric trains, monorail, supersonic aeroplanes and spacecrafts are some of the 20th century's contribution. Instead of steam, modern engines, they started using fuels like petrol, diesel, CNG, etc. Some engines run on electricity. Some very fast trains run on magnets. Human beings always wanted to fly like birds in the sky. Hot air balloons and gliders were the initial attempt to fly, and this led to the construction of aeroplanes. We choose the mode of transport depending on the distance we have to travel. Now the topic measurement. When you buy shoes for yourself, how do you know which size to buy? The shopkeeper measures your foot. Similarly, a carpenter measures the height and width of a cupboard before making its door, the size of the shoe, the height and the width, etc. All deal with the measurement of distance between two points. The quantities that can be measured are called physical quantities. Length, weight, volume, time, speed, and temperature are some quantities that can be measured. Comparing an unknown quantity with some known quantity, this is called measurement. When we compare an unknown quantity with some known quantity, then we are doing measurement. Now, result of measurement. The result of measurement has two parts. When you write any measurement, then we write two parts. One part is the number and another part is the unit. The known quantity which is used in measurement, so this is called a unit. For example, when we say that your height is 150 centimeter, then the measurement of your height is being expressed in a number, or that number is 150, and a unit centimeter. Arbitrary units of measurement. Arbitrary units of measurement means before the development of standard units of measurement, people used arbitrary units of measurement. Some of them are still in use at some places. Hand span, finger length, cubit. Cubit means length between the elbow and the fingertips. Foot length and arm length. These are examples of arbitrary units of measurement. Now, the people, earlier people, used different parts of our bodies to measure length. The distance of a step, the width of a finger, the length of the finger, that is called angul, etc., were some of the widely used units of length. Some other body parts, these used for measuring length, and names of their corresponding units are given as follows. Length of a foot, that is called a foot. Distance between the end of outstretched arm and chin, this is called a yard. Arm's length from elbow to fingertip, this is called cubit. Length of a step is called a pace. Length of foot, this is called a foot. So these methods of measuring length are called arbitrary units of length. Disadvantages of arbitrary units of measurement. We have seen that arbitrary units are made up of lengths of different body parts. These lengths can vary from one person to another. They don't have the same measurement. These methods of measuring lengths, they were not satisfactory because the length of the arm, foot and hand span varied from one person to another. They can create a lot of confusion. If one person is saying this length is 5 hand span and the second person say it is 6 or 4, so there will be there this can create a lot of confusion. As there would be no uniformity in measurement. Therefore, some standard units of measurement are needed and they don't change from time to time. They are uniform at all places.